Today's telecast is presented live from Brawltimore Scaryland in Red B&D Spike Stadium for today's game. The stadium is sold out and the atmosphere is electric. The fans want to see some hard-hitting carnage, and so do I.
I heard the city was famous for crabs, so if you get lucky tonight, Grim, make sure you take a shampoo with that Quell lotion and see a doctor.
The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for MFL action. The Full Metal Mayhem bang heads against the Brawltimore Razors. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Welcome to another game day here on the MFL Network. Grim Blitzrow along with my partner, Brickhead Mulligan.
How you doing?
Great city, isn't it, Bricks?
Fantastic city. My motel even has free color TV.
Oh, that's nice.
An ice machine that works.
Wow.
There was police tape blocking the bathroom because of the photographers in there, but other than that, no complaints. They give you free jelly at breakfast, too.
Sounds like a real winner. And it's first and ten.
Not one.
He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And he picks up about six on the play. And that'll be second down and four.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
I don't even get out of it.
First and eight to go.
Hot one. Hot two.
That's how you run the football. A pickup of seven on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown.
Why didn't the skeleton dance at the rock club, Grim?
I don't know.
He had no body to dance with. That's a pretty good one.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and ten. Ah, and the defense jumps outside to the table. If he was still talking, he'd probably be saying, psycho killer. Catch could say, what the fuck the fuck the fuck?
I don't know which guy.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
He had it for a second there. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Good throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and 1. And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown! And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Hot one, hot two.
The brain scrambler. Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one, hot two.
That's a catch for a 10-yard gain. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. It's unfortunate.
Hot two.
Oh, he just got crushed. Second down and more than the QB would like. And he'll throw that one out of bounds. Third down and the punter is warming up. And the defense just knocked the wind out of that quarterback. And they'll line up for the punt here. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10.
Two.
And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up 7. Second and 3.
Hot one, hot two.
Hot. 4.
Hot 1, hot 2.
That's a pass that went nowhere.
Nah, that's like me at the hotel bar every night.
And so at the end of one, we're all tied up. We'll be right back. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. He just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says we'll take it. And it's first and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot 8.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot 8.
The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is going to get ugly fast. Second down and long.
Hot 1, hot 2.
There aren't too many players that kids can look up to at home. I'm glad one guy is stepping up. Oh, what a brutal hit. Third and 2.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
4 yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Graham, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot.
I hope you covered your ears, Brick, because that was a Sonic Blast dirty trick. Oh, nice hit. First down and 9.
Hot 1, hot 2,
I'm pretty sure my baby sister can throw further than that. But she doesn't have to play against goddamn monsters.
Second down and 7. Third down and, well, good luck. Well, looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball. The drive was stalled, and here comes the field goal attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty.
And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appears to be cheating. He's just making shit up. If they don't pick it up here, offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. And this is going to be a rocket shot to the moon. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2.
When the defense calls Thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, you ever hear that Zappa song, Watch Out Where the Huskies Go? Don't you eat that yellow snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. But them fudge ice cream sandwiches, they didn't taste so good.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down in a very lot. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Third down and long.
Hot one, hot two.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And he held on to that one for a first down. First down and three.
Hot one, hot two.
For the touchdown. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, with a brutal hit! And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down and a lot. And the defense spiked the offensive water with strawberry peel. And now they can taste sound but can't remember what. Not much there, maybe a yard.
Why are they stopping the clock for the offense, Ben?
They're stopping it for their own offense. They're hungry for the ball, partner.
The ball? The pigskin? Bacon! I'm hungry for bacon!
Hey. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career. At this point, they're going to have to get the ball back by any means necessary. Or wasting two timeouts on the defense is really going to bite them in the ass. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he's got a chance for a good return here. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Caught for the first down. And it's first and...
Timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You gotta use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense.
Hot two, hot.
Moose.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Perfect pass and a score! Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. And this guy couldn't hit the side of a fallout shelter. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up?
Changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Did I kill him?
Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about bad hit.
Yeah, most likely.
And they stop the clock with their first time out to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy!
And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the carnage during today's halftime show. Obviously, they need to play a lot harder here in the second half to make a game of it.
Or they can start cheating and killing. That's what I do.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever.
With a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
Trust me, that hit was worse.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Nice pass. That catch is good for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and four.
Hot one.
Oh, and that's what they call the money shot. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was on to the races. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
Tackles. He takes a licking and keeps on ticking. first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
First and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down and long.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
And these guys think kicking is for pussies, Bricks. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Yeah, bigger than yours.
Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And it's first and 10. Tired of the quarterback's tight spirals. If this guy could talk before he died, what do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the fuck!
And it's first and 10. That would have been a disappointing run. It's even a worse throw. Second down and 9. Oh, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole up here. Talking to you.
And the quarterback calls a sonic. I don't know if he even had a target on that throw. There's no reason to go for it here, but they do anyway. And a perfect strike for a first down. That's a hell of a fourth down play. Thank you. First and four. And the cornerback is down.
Zoom in on his face. I want to see if the little bastard's crying.
Second down and a lot. You've got to catch that. Third down and the punter is warming up. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It's good. They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And it's first and ten. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Second down and ten.
Hot one, hot two. Eight.
And that's how you shock the monkey. Thunderclap. The offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. You need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jet, you son of a bitch.
It appears that the ref just received a pair of very expensive alligator skin shoes. They need to put some cement shoes on before this game slips away.
I always wanted a pair of alligator skin shoes, Grim. I heard, though, when you put them on, they feel just like chicken skin shoes.
First down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever.
Hot one, hot two.
It's 2 yard run before he stopped. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
One, hot two, hot eight.
Great catch for a big gain.
But still not enough for a first. Even I'm frustrated, and I'm a team agnostic.
That's the end of the third quarter. And look, folks, I'll be honest. I don't see a chance in hell in here. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Oh, and the defender cut off that pass like a suburban mom.
You ever get hit in the head with a football, Grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and ten. He blasts dropped it and picks up 7 yards right there. Second and three.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. Second down in a very lot. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. And that'll bring up third down and 7. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. And he misses that extra point.
Oh, look at clown shoes down there.
Is he wearing actual clown shoes?
I think so. It's probably why he missed.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
Now, what about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match.
They've used a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Those guys don't know which way forward is now. And that is caught for a first down. And it's first and 10. And that catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
One.
They weren't even on the same page on that play. Second down and 10.
Hot one.
He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And he snags it for 6. Touchdown! Touchdown! And they line up for the extra point. Kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. The defense better look out. The offense called them. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stopped after 3.
They usually stop me after 3, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Second down and 7. And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. first and 10. And that's why they call it the money shot. Nicely done for a first down.
If you get one more bullshit penalty, you get one more for free.
You also probably lose the game. Yeah. Just do the attack ref dirty trick.
And this is a first and long. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take more. First down in a mile. A pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down in a mile. Great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. Third down and a pussy hair. Two minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back after I top off my drink.
What did I do with that?
Third down and a sliver. Defense quickly calls a timeout. They want to get the ball back. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy. Oh, what a brutal hit! Wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
As same as Britz's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a compliment.
Second dip. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Third down, and they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. Third down and long.
Hot 1, hot 2.
He's got his beast boost working. The player just... hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. They go to the ground game and pick up the first. Nicely done. The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Can I kill him?
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting...
Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick. first and 10. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And the Razors lose their game in their own backyard, which definitely sucks for the fan, especially when your backyard is littered with dog shit like it is around here. And let's go down to the field and hear the MVP. He's a real role model for the kids, Bricks. That is, if you want your kids to be a roid-raging narcissist with uncontrollable verbal diarrhea.
Oh, that personality sort of has a name. It's called auto-Trumpism.
Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.